prophets, pastors, evangelists, and teachers to men, not to women, but to men. He gave gifts unto men. So when you hear these women, if you let them prophesy, that's fine. But that is not a prophet. That is someone who has the gift of prophecy. And all prophecy must be tried. And that is the truth. And even the prophet ministry must be verified by other prophets. Let one speak and let the other hold their peace, but verify. You can go on and on with this speculation. I guess the problem is that when someone declares that he is a prophet, that's what upsets everybody else, especially those who think they are a prophet when they're not. And you come to a prophet, with a real prophet, to him, and you say you're a prophet or you got a revelation, the prophet will know. He will know. And so you don't deceive him, and he won't deceive you. The true prophets don't deceive you. Almighty Yahweh has sustained this ministry and this prophet under every kind of adverse attack of charges, lies, innuendos, and quite true at all, Almighty Yahweh sustained this prophet. My name is Ben Scher. Why is it so important for me to declare to you the calling that God has given me? The Apostle Paul declares, I magnify my office. Is he wrong in doing that? The Apostle, sent to the saints of God, scattered abroad. I come behind, he said, no apostle. I have been given a revelation, a truth, a message, that even the other apostles eventually had to conceive that Paul was seeking a mystery. What is a mystery? That he was seeking a mystery or a secret.